In this segment, we're going to talk about higher order and coupled order ODEs. So we have higher or coupled ODEs. And what we want to be able to figure out is that how do we solve higher order and coupled ODEs by using our numerical methods. So this is just the background information which I'm going to show it to you. Examples of how to solve higher order and coupled ordinary differential equations are given in a separate segment. So let's see that how do we go about doing that. Now the first thing which I need to talk to you about is that all the methods which we have talked about, like Euler's method, Runge-Kutta second order method, Runge-Kutta fourth order method, we are only able to solve differential equations which are of this particular form. Which means that that we are only able to solve differential equations which are first order, and they can be written in this particular form which we have, and some initial condition is given. Surely the initial value is not necessarily supposed to be zero, it can be any number which is given to you. So, but since we have this as a first order ordinary differential equation form, what does that mean that we are only then relegated to solve only first order ordinary differential? What happens if we have coupled ordinary differential equations? What happens when we have higher order ordinary differential equations? How do we use our methods of Runge-Kutta second order method, fourth order method, and Euler's method to be able to solve differential equations which are of that form? So in order to do that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take an example and show you how you can reduce these coupled ordinary differential equations, in this case, into first order differential equations so that you can use your Runge-Kutta methods and Euler's method to be able to do that. So let's do that here. So let's suppose somebody gives me a coupled differential equations like this, 2d2y by dx squared plus 3dy by dx. Minus 5 dz by dx. So you're already finding out that the reason why you are writing coupled ordinary differential equations is because you already have two dependent variables, y and z, in this particular ordinary differential equation. And so you would need, and that's why you would need coupled ordinary differential equations, 7z is equal to e to the power minus x. So that's the first ordinary differential equation given to us. Then we are given another simultaneous ordinary differential equation, 2d2z by dx squared minus 29dy by dx plus 31dz by dx minus 37y plus 41z equal to sine of x. So these are the two second-order ordinary differential equations which are given to us, but they are coupled because you're already finding out that you have instance of y and z there, and then you have instance of y and z in the second one, so they have to be solved simultaneously. That's why they're called coupled ordinary differential equations. And then you have certain initial conditions. You need the initial condition of y. You need the initial condition on the first derivative of y. Then you need the initial condition on z. And then you will need an initial condition on the derivative of z. And now what we need to do is to be able to solve this set of coupled ordinary differential equations. Now, in order to be able to do that by using the numerical methods which we have been talking about, such as Euler's and Runge-Kutta methods, we need to reduce these coupled ordinary differential equations into some set of first-order ordinary differential equations, because we said that we can only use first-order differential equations for the numerical methods. So one of the things which I'm going to do is I'm going to dy by dx be equal to, let's suppose, u. So if I let dy by dx be equal to u, what's going to happen is that when I take this dy by dx equal to u and substitute it in here, I'll get du by dx. So that's how I'm reducing this to a first-order ordinary differential equation. And also, wherever there's an instance of dy by dx, for example, I'm going to put u there so that I will be able to represent it as a function of dependent variables and independent variables like I need it for the numerical methods. So I'm going to take dy by dx equal to u. So that will become my first ordinary differential equation. In fact, dy by dx equal to u becomes my first ordinary differential equation itself. Then I'll also assume, I'll also say let dz by dx be equal to w. And this becomes my second ordinary differential equation. And the reason why I'm doing that is because once I substitute dz by dx equal to w, so for example, in this particular equation, when I substitute dz by dx equal to w, I get dw by dx. So I get the first derivative of w respect to x here. And whatever there's a dz by dx, for example, here, I'll substitute a w there. So you can see that this is a mechanism of being able to reduce my second order coupled ordinary differential equations into first order differential equations. So let me go ahead and do the substitution and see what happens. So let's suppose if I do the substitution, these two substitutions, let me go ahead and do them in the two differential equations which are given to me.